This is part two of modeling a temple. And let's go ahead and put some bricks on the side here. All right. So select the main body here. And let's choose that edge, cursor to selected. Put our 3D cursor right there and Shift A and bring in a cube. Let's go into edit mode and scale it down and figure out how big we want our bricks to be. Scale this in the X. Bring it down. So we want it to be pretty much in the middle there and on both sides. I'm just debating if I want to make it a little bit longer that way. Keep it like a normal brick. All right, so there's our brick. And let's add a bevel. Maybe we'll go for two. Like that. Maybe a little bit less. If we can. Okay, so the idea would be that I would want two different bricks. So we got that one, and then I do another one, and I just copy it and bring it down. I'm not gonna array it. It would be there. Go into edit mode, grab that face and make it longer, let's say. Just thinking about this, I'm going to try to see if I would want it a different size on the side as well. Let's try that. Let's take both of these. I hope they're not too big. Scaling them anyhow. Alright, let's see. We'll do this in object mode. We'll try scaling them in the Z. I'm just getting a sense for that. This one a little bit closer, bring it under, and these can, I think, stick up. And do I want them inside this groove there, like that? So if that comes back, this is going to stick, it's going to be wider anyhow. Let's scale this in the X. That, and the bricks would fit under there. We'll work on that a little bit. Might make the top of this. Let's make this. Well, that's pretty good. Well, we'll come down a little bit. Let's just raise the top of this a little bit. This will come out in the back as well. I might prefer it without the smooth shading. push him into that. That's okay like that. Okay, so let's take these and join them together. Like that. Oh, no, I have to apply the bevel. Well, I'm not sure if I do. Maybe I will though. Apply the bevel to all these guys. Probably counts. Not too crazy out. It's about to go crazy from what we're gonna do, but it'll be fun. Okay, let's do that. And then let's select the building. Shift S cursor to select it. Let's see if we can mirror these over nicely with respect to the building. Okay. Did I not take smooth shading off this guy? Well, maybe I did. Maybe I just did. I think maybe I just did. All right. Now, know if I can. That's okay, I could do that. They don't quite, you know, mirror onto there, but I could take a piece of that, control L. Nah, I guess I can't get them all. All right, let's just grab all these. And then do control L for linked. We'll look at the top, maybe the side. Push them in and just get a sense for how far they are in the front versus the back. That kind of thing. There we go. It's a nice little touch. We'll worry about the roof later. Yeah, so what I was thinking of doing was modeling some more of these pieces here. So I'm going to go to the next layer and Shift-C, bring my 3D cursor back, go to front view and open up the side panel, and I've got an image in here of these various things, and I thought I'll make this one, and then maybe I'll make something else. I don't know which one. You know, maybe just that one. Well, I'll start with this. We'll see. This is going to be pretty high poly. So the way I'm going to do this is Shift A, put in a plane, rotate X90, select vertex, whatever, select it, and Alt M, merge it center. Alright, and bring this up to the top. It doesn't have to be perfectly centered or anything. This is just our interpretation of the thing. I'm going to get rid of the transform, and I'm just going to E and G and trace the profile, roughly trace the profile. This will end up giving a lot of polys, but it's okay. And we'll just make it our own kind of pot-like structure. I know it has a real name, but I forget what it is. I'm not going to do every detail. Okay, so just tracing the outline, putting down points. Pretty quick. And when it gets down to here, I think I will jut it in. Where am I? Yeah. And I'll bring it out. In a little bit. And then out. We'll see what that looks like. We can always edit this. Come down to about here. I'll do one more and then I'm going to come back to there. Okay, so I've got that last point selected, and I'll select the first point, open the side panel, scroll up to the top, and under X, make that zero, so it'll zero it out. Okay, close the side panel, back into object mode, and there's my profile. I'm going to come over to add modifier, and I'm going to choose screw, but in the Y, and I'll get that. Okay. And then I'm going to come over to subdivision surface. Be nice to get away with one. You know, I could go back into edit mode and I could delete that vertex. And let's just have a look at the top. And sometimes that's a little bit problematic. Looks pretty good. So I'm just going to go ahead and apply that. And that's it. Done. Okay, let's move this back to the first layer. Okay. And set origin to geometry. Oh yes, and I hit that. And there it is. Let's just scale in object mode. And we'll put on smoothing. I'll bring it over to this side. Stick it on there. So we jumped up a bit. There we go. That was fun, actually. I could have a look at whether or not I like any more of those. I want to do this one real quick just to do the technique again. We don't even have to. We could just, you know, click there with the 3D cursor. Shift A, plane, rotate X90, edit mode, Alt M for the vertices, and it is nice when we do start though at the center though. That's okay though. Yeah, we can do it this way easily. Okay, so let's do something with this. Let's move that up to there and let's get to E and G, X, come out to here. E and G, we just have fun with this stuff. Oh, E and G. We'll try to make some indentations, not even really following exactly, just making something of our own and trying to see how it's going to turn out. G, Z, and come on down. Let's go in. D and G, just make a little notch. E and G. I don't know how visible it will be in the grand scheme of things, though, but come around. To there. Let's come down. Let's go in a little bit. And GZ, we'll come right down. And we'll finish it up. We'll come out a little bit and down. B and G will come in and then we'll go out. So you don't always follow the base all that specifically. Okay, to there. E and G X. I don't know where we started exactly, so what we'll do is we'll just go like this, bring this back, and just go scale X0. It does the same thing. Okay, so there's our profile, And let's do screw in the Y. Wow. We'll add a subdivision surface. And then we'll come back in, and then we can edit these points. That's the cool thing. If we think that's a little bit messed up. Look at that, it's beautiful. It really is. Yeah, I think that's just fine for what I want to do. Well, maybe I will get rid of that bottom point though. Just have a look at this. See if this is a little bit tight here. Pull that out. Well, no, I like that groove. And so let's sharpen it. I got an extra point in there, eh? We've overlapped, I think. Maybe we'll do that though. Now, another thing you could do, of course, is you could select two and you could go W. Subdivide. You could put another point and work with that. All right, anyways, that's good enough. So I'm going to go ahead and apply the screw modifier, and let's move this baby back here and figure out where she's gonna go. Certainly not there. I'm scaling object mode again. I don't mind. All right, well, I don't want it right beside there. Maybe I'll make that even smaller. Now this one, the more I think about it, let's put it over there. I probably shouldn't have closed it off. So, because I think this one should be open. I'm gonna grab all those. Let's see if I can just delete those faces. And maybe all I need to do is put on solidify. Let's try solidify. Let's actually move solidify. What did I just do? Did I move solidify out? That'd be okay. That ring is a little bit rough. That's probably all right. Okay. So that's how we could do those very quickly. Let's have a look at where we're at. Let's do these little structures along the side there. What I might do is just take one of these bricks, Control L linked, Shift D to copy, P to make a new object, and origin of geometry, bring this out and have a look at it and see if it would serve the purpose. Let's hide this background image. Probably don't need it anymore at all, anyhow. Yeah. Okay. I mean, I think if this was by the water, these things could be used to tie up the boats. Let's try arraying this. Why? Too many. It's just blocks, you know, blocks, blocks, blocks. Let's apply that. Let's choose this as the central point. And see if we can mirror this nicely across. Just a thought. Just to see. No, I don't like that anymore. All right. Okie dokie. So, let's just have a quick look at that roof. Okay, so it extends just past the pillars and past the bricks there. So it's doing the front part okay. Let's see if we can get the back part. Not that. Now it's obviously got to go out sideways as well. So let's grab that side and this side and look from the front. Scale this in the X. Okay. So let's inset. We're gonna come out not quite. Okay, we'll inset to do this and then we'll come out which is not quite as far. So let's inset a good amount. That. Let's extrude up from the top. E scale. Check the scale, see if it's coming out evenly. Looks pretty good. E, and let's see how high this one's going to go. I'm not sure. Alright, similar. No, that's going to be under. It's higher, but underneath. Come out again, maybe even a little further this time. That's fine. Even like that might be all right. Well, that might be a bit much. Let's scale that back in. Well, we can always play with it. I need some space underneath to hang some things. That would be okay. I think that's it, and then we get into the roof itself. Okay, so I'll stop at that point. And I'll probably do the roof separate, so let's keep that and add bevel. Smoothing. Let's try smoothing with something like that. So let's hang those things. Once again, let's take one of these. Control L, Shift D, P to make a new object. Select the object, origin of geometry, and then bring it to where you need it. And we need it up here. Not there. We're going to need it over here somewhere. Let's rotate Z 90. Why did we do that? We're going to rotate X 90, but this is not going to be the final size anyhow. Okay, let's go into this thing. let's select it all. Let's hit scale. Let's scale this in the Y. Move it back under. Maybe we can actually maybe can be a bit bigger. Well, I want it longer or wider than it is. Alright, anyways. Let's go to the front. Let's have these like that. And let's try arraying these in the X. Apply rotation and scale. When that happens, when it's not going the way it's supposed to go and you're in the right axis. If I do that and I go over, I'm going to have some trouble when I do them down the side. So I think I'm going to reduce the count. I'm going to have to reduce it a couple of times and have it within this region. Let's try that. And let's just try doing one on the side. Rotate Z 90. All right, where is it going to be over here? Let's see. Let's control 3. See what it's like here. Yeah, this side is going to be a bit different because it's longer. So let's up the count here. Nah, you know what? They don't go down the sides. They only go down the front. The front and the back, right? They do go down the sides. I take it all back. They do go down the sides. All right. Well, let's do this though. Let's make it look a little bit more. More balanced. Yeah. Just like this. We'll leave a little bit of space on either side. Just like the front one. Okay, like that, maybe back. I'm just playing around here. Okay, cool. I'm changing my mind as we do it. That's better for me. This one too. That one too. Okay, let's go ahead and apply that and use this as the mirror object. And let's mirror this in the Y with respect to this. And it didn't go that well for us, so that's okay. Let's go ahead and apply that and just take these box select, just get a piece of them, and then control L and bring them in. Look at the side and get roughly the same distance. Okay, and for this one, I just keep wondering if I should increase this so that it looks like it almost makes a square. Similar amount showing on either side. I think maybe that's the way to go. So let's just take this one, Shift D, and let's just copy it over to the other side. It's the same on the front and the back of these things. Okay, like that. Okay. Let's apply that. That's already applied. Let's apply that and let's link these things together at least. Cool. Now, you know, although it's not in the original, I like the idea maybe of having these here as well, but smaller, I guess. Let's get rid of these ones. Control L. I won't get every piece though, will I? It down globally. It's pretty small, I admit. Origin and geometry. Tried to push that in. I could have got rid of the backs of the diamonds as well. I didn't ever did that. Centered. Let's try this. 150,000. Okay, separate them. I don't want this exactly aligned with that. Maybe in between. Let's see how it goes though. Each one. If it falls out of alignment, may not be a big deal. Does that look any good? Too hard to see because they're too small. All right, I think I'll do that. So I think I'm not gonna apply it yet. I'm just gonna copy this stuff. Shift D, rotate Z90. Which one is this? Is that backward? That's backward, so I'm bringing it over here. That's three. I'll add one more for the sides. No, I won't. No, I won't. I'll just even it out. Touchdown. Yeah, it's sort of a similar amount of space there. Okay. Shift D, rotate Z 180. Bring it over here. Didn't plan to do this, but I do think it looks, I think it looks okay. I hope it does. You tell me. Okay, that's pretty even. Let's take this one, Shift D, rotate Z 180. And we'll do what we can. Control one for the back, one for the front, control one for the back. Okay. It's a lot of squares. It's a lot of squares. I'm starting to think that there's too many of these. But you know what? Maybe it's just me because I'm looking at it so much. So I'm going to go ahead and apply that. And that. That. And that. And then I'm going to select them all and join them, and then I'm going to do something. I'll show you. All right, so the thing looks busy, so take them, get rid of them. And does it look bare? Does it look better with those? Without them? We'll leave them for now. Okay. So this is what we got so far. And I'll get rid of that. See that? See it like that? Oh no, 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 I don't. I'll do go back to that. Alright, well, okay, I think I'm going to leave it at that for the time being. We don't have too many more things to do. I was thinking of putting a chain across here. We'll see if that ever happens. We'll do the roof part there. And, yeah, we're getting close to being done. Thanks for watching.